Hi, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today we're going to be showing you how to do a valve adjustment on our 2007 Honda TRX 400 EX. A couple of things you want to look for that tells you you may need to check your valves is if it's getting harder to start or if you hear a lot of ticking in the top end. That usually indicates either A, they're too tight, or B, they're too loose. So it starts by just taking off all the plastic, pulling the fuel tank, and then there's a couple of covers on the top of the engine that will allow us to access the rock arms where we actually perform the adjustment. So let's get started. All right, first thing we need to do is just release the latch, push down on the seat, lift up, and off she comes. Continue on. You're going to find that the majority of the panels on most of the Honda units are held in by these little plastic rivets. There's no real direct tool to get them out. I either use a pair of needle nose pliers or a set of side cutters or a screwdriver to get them pried out. Believe it or not, these little plastic rivets are the number one selling part for Honda. They come in a package of 10. You might as well get a full pack because you'll end up going through them. Next, you're going to have a couple of 10 millimeter bolts. There's one here at the back, one up toward the front, and then there's a plastic rivet right here that needs to be pulled out. This center section, all you have to do is grab it in the center and pull straight out. That'll expose another plastic rivet here. And then a 5 millimeter Allen back at the back. Now with all that removed, she'll just slide right off. To remove the tank, you just have 2 10 millimeters up front, one right here, then one on the other side. Once you get those out and out of the way, just turn off your fuel. Disconnect the hose going down to the carburetor, and then the tank will lift right out. From that point, you have a couple more plastic rivets, and then two more 10 millimeter bolts holding in this plastic cover. Now we can lift it up and out of the way. That exposes the 4 caps that cover up where you adjust the valves. What we need to do here is go ahead and pull our access plugs on the side of the crankcase, the one in the center, which is a 12 millimeter, the one up top, which is a 6 millimeter. And now with the covers removed, we can get to our crankcase bolt. And what we want to do is rotate it counterclockwise until we see a little T with a hash mark through this little window. So I'm going to rotate it counterclockwise, and in just a few seconds you'll see the T come up. Alright, that's the F, and we want the T. Alright, there's the T. And that puts us at top dead center. With her set to top dead center, we can go and remove our caps, and that will expose the adjustment bolts. Each one of these caps has an O-ring on the inside, so you probably want to replace those, especially if you're noticing some leakage up there. Now, what you got here is a pinch bolt and then the adjustment head, which is a flat blade screwdriver. You break the pinch bolt loose, and now you can adjust the valve lash with this bolt right here. So now we're going to use a 0.1 millimeter feeler gauge on the intake side. We're going to get it in between the adjustment and the top of the valve, we're going to tighten down on the adjustment flathead screw, bring it down, let it engage it. You want it to grab it, but you don't want to compress down on it. Once you feel like you've got a little bit of tension on it, that's where it needs to be. So now we can bring our 10 millimeter wrench back in and tighten down that pinch bolt to hold it in place. But you want to keep your screwdriver up top so it doesn't move the adjustment screw. Now all you need to do is the other intake valve at 0.1 millimeters and then go over to the two exhaust valves, same procedure, but they're set to 0.12 millimeters. When you put the caps back on, you want to put just a light layer of oil on the O-rings. We do this so it doesn't get bunched up and try to, you know, rip the O-rings. Makes them seal better and not dry out as quickly. Now the caps just need to be snugged back down with our 22 millimeter wrench. Not a lot of torque required here, guys. Take it easy on them. Now to get the engine button back up, just replace your two access covers on the crankcase. All right, we're with our inspection covers back in place all the way around. All that's left now is just to put all the plastics in the fuel tank and all those little rivets back in there. And honestly, I'm going to leave them all for right now because we're going to go a little bit further into this engine. So you may want to check out those videos. All right, well, if you have any questions or comments, just leave them below. And if you need any, you know, parts, come see us at Partzilla.com. And until next time, thanks for watching.